down, so hope. Down, sir. Hey.
It's good.
Down. Eat that watermelon, kick.
It's good.
Down. Santino's friends are crabby, hike.
Since I'm gonna have to need you to re-register your badge, please. Thank you. Call back up there.
Whoops. Yeah, I accidentally hiked that ref, just so you know. I don't know if y'all are watching. Balance hit.
Killian, you're streaming. Oh boy, Twitter's no commentators.
The heck?
Hello, world, and welcome to the most hyped-up match without commentators. I am your host for tonight. F my life, but I had work, and I decided to skip work for a little bit and do this shit. I'm going to actually enable my voice in-world also.
How's the heck?
All right, ladies and gents, bear with me for a few seconds while I actually get my brain into the game. Okay, here we go. So I believe the Packers are leading at the moment, and the Packers have the ball as we speak. Yes, that is correct. All right, let's do this. The ball is snapped. They roll to the right. And it's up. Caught by Michael, and Kazi was just on that. As always, and to be expected, it's a really fast-paced game, so I highly doubt that I'm going to have any breathing time here. The ball is snapped. They're rolling to the left. He's looking for a pass. It's up, deep, and it is caught by the third Lieutenant Dan, or the first top hat. The ball is snapped, rolls to the right, rolls back to the left, looking for a receiver. It's up, intercepted by Kazi, first in the 4th-yard line. Alrighty. They're in their red zone. Hopefully they can get out of there quick enough before they get sacked. Ball is snapped, rolls to the right. He has an opening, he takes it, he's going out. And... Just a few inches away from that first down. Tackled by the other Lieutenant Dan. Ball is snapped, you're also right, rolls. That's up. Caught by Chris Taco. And he gets tackled by Cameron Cora for a pickup of 11 yards. First and 24.
Down to
snaps the ball, rolls to the left. He's looking for a receiver. Might run. He's going for it. He has the room. He keeps going. Gets tackled by Brian Joseph, 23, for a pickup of 13 yards. First and
37. Down to
snaps the ball, rolls to the right. Looking for an open receiver. And it is caught by Chris Taco. And yet again, tackled by Cameron Cora for just a few inches.
Down set.
Ball is snapped, rolls to the right. He's looking for an open receiver. was caught by Mr. Gonzalez. I mean, I'm sorry if I can't see their current names, only their original SL names. So please bear with me on that one. Ball was snapped and caught by Cameron Cora. Oh, no, actually, my bad. Caught by Chris Taco and tackled by Cameron Cora. They've been pushed all the way into their red zone. Can the Reapers score here? Ball is snapped, rolls to the right. He's looking for an open receiver. He's going for it. He chooses to run. He's off. He's almost there, and he gets tackled. I believe in inches. Yeah, there we go. He picks up 9 yards. Second and one, 30-yard line.
Down set.
Ball is snapped, rolls to the left. Will he try another run? Is he looking for a receiver? Rolls back to the right. And it is caught. By Chris Taco.
Say hi.
Ball is up, and it is good. 7-7. Luckily, the 5% did not fail Skinner this time. The ball is up. Goes down deep middle. Is caught by Cameron Cora. Rolls to the right. Finds himself in a sea of red and is tackled down by Skinner Sky Tower on the 34-yard line.
That's a hike.
Ball is snapped. Rolls to the left. It's up, across the field, caught by Brian Joseph. He's running, getting a few extra yards, and he's brought down. Actually, this is very confusing. Brian Joseph caught the ball, and yet another similar name, Gonzalez.
Down, sir. Hi.
It's like, we're currently trying to get more commentators in. Please bear with us as this happens. Ball is snapped and is caught by Crevin. He is tackled by Mr. Extraordinary. Picks up 17 yards. Packers are at the 29-yard line. First and 10.
Down, sir.
The ball is snapped. Rolls to the right. Looking for a receiver. And it is intercepted by Chris Taco. He's still up. He's running. He might actually make it. Oh, he's just a few inches away. He is down. He was brought down by Cameron Cora, who picks up 26 yards. First and 10, 49-yard line for the Reapers.
Down set.
Ball is up. Caught by Gonzalez. He's looking for an opening. He's running. gets tackled by Dante, picks up 24 yards. First and 10, 27-yard line for the Reapers. Ball is snapped, rolls to the right. There's the ball, caught by Chris Taco. Picks up 12 yards. First and 10 on the 16-yard line for the Reapers. Ball is snapped, rolls to the left. Looking for some breathing room, and he gets tackled by Cheese Quicksand and loses 10 yards. Second and 20 for the Reapers on the 26-yard line. Ball is snapped, rolls to the right. Goes a little bit further back, rolls back to the left. Ball is up, and it is caught by Chris Taco. He's trying to make it to the first and 10. Ooh, gets tackled by Dante. First and a few inches. I believe a few yards, actually like 2 yards. Reapers are almost there. Just a few more yards and they can turn this around on the Packers for a little bit. Ball is snapped, rolls to the right, heads back to the left, goes back into the middle, keeps going left, crosses it, intercepted by Crevin, and he is still going. He might actually make it. He has not been brought down, and there he is. Kazi brings him down. He gets to pick up 32 yards, first and 10 on a 29-yard line.
All right, I'm here now.
And now we are joined by Jade. I don't feel so lonely anymore. The ball is snapped. He rolls to the right. Rolls back to the left. He's looking for a receiver. And is caught by Brian Joseph. And he gets first down. Picks up the 10 yards. They're in first and 39 for the Packers. So how are you today, Jade, besides your script issue?
I'm fine. I'm just definitely fine. Hopefully, I don't get booted again, but I have to forcibly wear my uniform to just stay in. And the ball is snapped.
Rolls to the right. He's looking for a receiver. He's going to choke, and he is brought down by Ricky Ward-Heaney and loses 11 yards. Second and 21 on the 28-yard line for the Packers. So, Jade, who are you putting your money on?
I'm always a Reaper's head. Even though, granted, Mike is my boy, Cheese is my boy. Sorry, Packers, but yeah, it's kind of iffy, but just the Reapers. Tino knows to kill me.
And there is a timeout by the home team.
Well, what about you? What's your prediction about this one? Even though it's
Well, unlike you, Miss Reapers fan, I am going with the Packers. So we are divided on this, even though we're on the same team.
We're ready whenever.
Rookies unite.
We'll fight over it later. And the ball is snapped. Rolls to the right. Looking for a receiver. It is up. It is down short. And the pass is incomplete. Fourth and 3 for the Packers on the 46-yard line.
I'll probably ask for that.
They might try and run the ball on this one. Who knows? Both teams are very strange when it comes to this. The ball is snapped and rolls to the right. A quick pass down the middle. It is caught by Brian Joseph, and he gets tackled by Chris Taco. Picks up 8 yards.
Good, whenever.
Snaps the ball, rolls to the right, rolls back to the left, looks deep, somebody's open deep, can he catch the ball, and is caught by Dante, tackled by Skinner's Guy Tower to pick up 37 yards, first and 10, in the 9-yard line, I believe. And there's another timeout by the home team. Go Dante! Just when you think That man cannot catch. He is left wide open to punish you for it.
We're ready, by the way.
We're good. We're good.
The ball is back in play. Will they go for another quick pass, or will they wait it out? Will they run it? We're about to see. They snap the ball, rolls to the right. He's looking for a pass. It is up in a sea of red and yellow. And it is caught by Lieutenant Nan. The score is now 13-7. They are getting ready for the kick. Oh, they have to fix the field yet again.
These teams are one of the most interesting matches to watch. You can't even tell which one is either. You wanted them to win or lose, but it is so intense. The suspense is killing me.
Yeah, well, everybody has their favorites, but at the end of the day, if we put them skill-wise, they're both evenly matched. It will just come down to that little mistake, or like last time, that 5% from Skynyrd. And yes, he's never going to be able to lift that down anymore.
We good, ref?
And Torov is getting ready to kick the ball.
Down, set, and...
And it is good. 14-7. Leading the Packers.
As I said, these teams are really evenly matched. Both of them are always catching up on one another. But it can always come down to one tiny flaw and it changes everything.
Oh, yes. So far, it's been that one interception that brings it back to the other side and then back and forth. It's just that overwhelming fight to take the lead. The ball is up. It's deep to the right, or deep to the left, depending on which side you're looking at from, and is out. Oh, and that is first. There we go, ladies and gentlemen. I believe I wouldn't really know if we have cheerleaders right now, because I just jumped in here out of nowhere. So please bear with me. We do have cheerleaders. Excellent. So give us a few minutes while our streamer gets up and ready. And as for the sponsors, do forgive me. I do not have that card available on me, so you can chop my head off later. All right, ladies.
Can't hide.
And we are back. Thank you, ladies, for the great show. And seems that both teams are still in the locker room. So, Jade, what do you think is going to happen on this second half?
Oh, the second half, the Reapers need to pick up the pace and whatever momentum they have, they can get it. Well, the Packers know since they're in the lead. Let's see if they don't bring any holes for them for the Reapers to see so they can get the opportunity. Because, you know, both teams, once they see an opportunity, they strike it. So it's going to be one even game and one even out match. So we'll see if one of them goes out to the end.
Well, it looks like the Packers are already on the field. And the Reapers are coming out now.
I don't know. You want him to be in there? Because we're not in charge of media, you know.
Yep. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, the second half is just a few moments away from getting started. Can the Packers maintain their lead? Or will the Reapers make a comeback? Or will it be a tie like in the first game of the preseason? We will find out right after they actually kick the piss out of the ball.
And the ball is in play.
And the ball is up. It is deep middle. It is caught by Chris Taco. He's running down the middle, heads down to the right, turns around to the left, is looking for an opening. And he's brought down by the other Lieutenant Dan, the first, or Alf, as many know him. Ball is snapped, rolls to the right. Rolls back to the left. The ball is up, and it is caught by Chris Taco. And he might actually just be gone. He's going away.
Can the Packers catch up to him?
He almost had it. He is brought down. 59 yards. Ladies and gentlemen, Chris Taco wanted to make it all the way. Brought down by Krevin.
They're coming back.
Ball snapped. Rolls to the left. It is up. It's deep. It's out. Looks like the Reapers had a really strong pep talk about being super aggressive on this half because they've come out with really aggressive right now.
Beep, aggressive, kick some butt.
Okay. The ball is snapped, rolls to the left, rolls to the right, and it is up, and it is caught by Chris Taco, and he is brought down. Like Michael Slay picks up 5 yards.
The Packers are not letting them get that touchdown. They're almost home. They just want to get a little squeeze. Let's see how the Reapers will play this out.
They need to be careful with an interception, too. And the ball is snapped, rolls to the left. The ball is up, and a quick pass. It is caught.
Touchdown?
There he goes.
Yep.
A touchdown. Ladies and gentlemen, we have ourselves a tied game yet again. Oh, well, God. If they don't miss this kick, but.
All right, the ball is in play. Let's see if the kick is good. And it's good.
And it is good. They are now 14-14.
Ooh, the tied game. This is going to be intense now. Now the fun begins. Let's see if both teams will keep up the momentum on each other or it will be the same with the Packers winning again with the overtime if it leads there.
And the ball is up. It's going down deep middle. And it is caught by Brian Joseph. Going up the middle. Heads over to the left. And he's brought down by Tony Pergue, I believe. I'm trying to remember names. Not an easy job. So do forgive me if I murder your name. And the ball is snapped. Rolls to the right. Rolls back to the left. He's looking for an open receiver. Again, deep. Caught by Dante. For 23 yards. First and down on the 43-yard line. That is the second time they have left Dante wide open.
And he gets tackled by Jay Gonzalez.
Snaps the ball, rolls to the right. Throws the ball. Intended pass was incomplete. I did not honestly see the ball fly, so I did not know where it went. Okay. It was shot low, that's why. And the ball snapped, rolls to the right. He's looking for an open receiver. He might actually run it, and he goes for the run. Picks up 2 yards. Third and 8. 45-yard line.
He gets tackled by Biz.
That's my boy, Biz. The ball is snapped. He rolls to the left. Rolls back to the right. The ball is up. It is caught by Brian Joseph. Ooh. It's tackled by Kazi. Picks up 7 yards. 4th and 1 for the Packers. Ball is snapped. Rolls to the left. This is looking for a pass. The play was stopped. I do believe somebody flew off their ball accidentally.
Mm-hmm.
So I believe it'll be a redo in this case. As you all know, or if you're not aware, it is a glitch. It's not that they intentionally fly off 20 meters, jump over people's heads, kick them in the helmets, and get to the position they want. I guess we have had that complaint already. Snaps the ball, rolls to the left. It is a quick pass to the other side, and it's caught yet again by Brian Joseph. Gets brought down by Kazi. Picks up 5 yards.
44-yard line, 1st and 10. Great tackle by Cosmo.
She's been on them today. Snaps the ball, rolls to the left. Is looking for a receiver. He's rolling back to the right, and it is up, and it is caught by Michael Slate and tackled down by Mr. Extraordinary. Picks up 12 yards. 1st and 10 on a 32-yard line.
Down, sir.
Snaps the ball, rolls to the right. This rolls back to the left. Then it is up deep. Can Dante catch it? And he catches it! Touchdown, ladies and gentlemen! 20-14 for the Packers, leading yet again.
I thought for a minute it was down to an interception, but it was caught.
It was very close, but Dante was there.
Great catch by Dante. Great catch. Ball is in play.
Tora will be kicking the piss out of it yet again. It's up.
And it's good.
21-14, Packers leading. Now, can the Reapers counterattack?
Down. I got you mustard right here, Ike.
Ball is kicked up down deep middle. It is caught by Gonzalez. He's going down the middle, rolls to the left. Is looking for some space. He's actually going to make some extra yards. Picks up 29 yards for 1st and 10 on the 28-yard line.
Down set.
Ball is snapped, rolls to the right. Looks for a receiver, goes deep, goes over, and it was incomplete. 2nd and 10 on the 27-yard line.
All right, I'll try to do the ball play after this snap.
Down set.
Ball is not rolls to the right, and he's trying to make a good throw here, and he throws it, caught by Chris Taco, and he tackles by Cameron Cora, and he picks up 16 yards. First down. By the Reapers. On the 1st and 10th on the 42-yard line.
Down, sir.
while the staff rolls to the right. And he makes a run for it, and he goes, still goes to the right, turns up, and he's trying to run it, and he throws it. Ooh. Chris Tucker across the ball again, and he gets tackled by Cameron again. Another first down by the Reapers.
Skinner's footwork really throws off the Packers' defense. He made them think he was going to run and make them collapse on him and went back multiple times.
And snaps and he rolls to the right. Will he? Ooh, and he gets tackled by Odit. Loses 2 yards.
You're not wanna. You're no quarterback is happy when they see Odit in their face, that's for sure.
First thing, if you can't contain Odit, oh god, you're in some deep trouble. Ball is up and he rolls to the left, and he tries to get back to get some yardage, and he throws the ball, and the pass is incomplete.
Just misses, too. They were right there.
Ball is up and he rolls to the left, and he rolls back to the right, trying to gain some yardage here to get the throw, and two on the back. Ooh, and then Chris Tucker caught the ball, and he gets tackled by Odit again. 4th and 3, Reapers on the 37-yard line. Ball is up and he rolls to the left, then he rolls back to the right, and he gets back up the middle, and he throws it, catches it by Chris Tucker, and he's coming up in the middle. One more pack to beat, and he's coming up again.
And he's gone. Going. He actually make it.
He made it.
Chris Taco with the outplay.
Mm-hmm. And he missed the touchdown. Packers 21, Reapers 20. It'll be a tie again once the kick is good. Ball is in play.
This is exactly what everybody was expecting for tonight.
And it's good. Packers 21, Reapers 21. All tied up. This is supposed to be a very fun match indeed. Can the Reapers make it out on top, or will it be another Packers win? I'm sure they don't want that. I'm really sure they don't.
I don't think any of them really wants to lose, but it will come down to it might actually just come down to the clock and who has that the ball at the ending minutes.
And Cameron receives the kick, and he comes up in the middle trying to get some yardage there, and he gets tackled by Gonzalez, picks up 22 yards. First down and on the Packers 22nd yard. Your turn. Because I'm trying to get
And the ball is snapped, and he rolls to the left. He's looking for a receiver who can actually run. He goes for the run. He has room. He's trying to get the 10 yards, and he makes more than that. Picks up 16 yards. First and 10 on the 37-yard line for the Packers.
Smart run.
Down, sir. Hey.
Ball is snapped, rolls to the right. Looks for a receiver, rolls back to the left. The ball is up, cross field, and is caught by Brian Joseph. Might actually get the... Oh my god. These cross throws today.
I see a sea of red. I see red. All red on the poor little yellow.
Well, as long as it's not red, red blood, we're good. I don't need any dead bodies. And the ball is snapped. And it rolls to the right. Rolls back to the left. Trying to juke the defense a little bit. Another cross throw. Ooh, just a little bit under. Who was his intended receiver there? I believe that was Michael Slate. Yes, it was Michael Slate. And they're setting up. They snap the ball. Roll to the right. Rolls back to the left, goes into the middle, rolls back again yet to the right, and is up, intercepted by Kazi, and she is brought down by Alf.
Nice interception by Cosmo.
And this is not looking good for the Packers. The ball is snapped, rolls to the right, rolls back to the left. The ball is up, looking for Chris Tucker yet again. He catches the ball, and he is brought down by Brian Joseph. Picks up 14 yards. First and 10, 47-yard line for the Reapers.
Down, sir. Hey.
The ball is snapped, rolls to the right, rolls back to the left a little bit, goes back to the right. He's very well contained, and ooh, he is brought down by Odif and loses 15 yards, second and 25
ooh,
on the 39-yard line for the Reapers. That is not something you want to happen. You must be careful with Odif. The ball is snapped. He rolls to the left, rolls back to the right. He's looking for a receiver, and it is caught by Chris Tucker, and he's brought down by Michael Slate. Third and 13 on the 50-yard line for the Reapers.
Down, sir.
The ball is snapped. He rolls to the left, rolls back to the right. He throws it to the middle and is caught by Gonzalez. Ooh, Cameron Cora was there and picks up 13 yards. Fourth and inches on the 37-yard line for the Reapers.
Down, sir.
Ball is snapped, rolls to the left, rolls back to the middle, and is looking for Chris Tucker yet again. The ball is caught, and he is brought down. First and 10 on a 28-yard line. I'm noticing they're both doing the same exact cross play where they have the receivers on the opposite side of where the strong side is, which is something very interesting. The ball is snapped, rolls to the left, rolls back to the right, and he goes up and is deep, and he did not find it. It's intended receiver. Incomplete. Second and 10 on a 28-yard line.
Both teams are not giving each other the play that they wanted. At all, down, this is getting intense on both sides. And while it's snapping, it rolls to the left.
Nicole's in the middle. Call run. He's running.
He's running, and he gets tackled by
Cameron Cora. Picks up 8 yards. Mm-hmm. There we go.
And that's the end of the third quarter.
Down, sir.
Ball is snapped. Rolls to the left. He's being pushed back a lot. Chris Tucker's looking for the ball. He had to get rid of it.
He's getting a lot of pressure from the Packers. A lot of it from the Packers' defensive side.
He's doing good at getting rid of the ball when he realizes he doesn't have any more room.
Mm-hmm.
He snaps the ball, rolls to the left. He might actually run here. He does. He makes the extra yardage. He's got the first 10. He might actually keep going. And he is brought down by Brian Joseph and picks up 13 yards. First down on the, what is that, 7th, I believe? Yeah, 7th.
Yeah, it's the 7th. Yeah, 7th. Yeah.
I'm sorry if I randomly spaz out. My brain fails. It's just tired. And he snaps the ball, rolls to the left, and it is up. Deep pass. Ooh, I do believe incomplete.
It's incomplete.
And it is incomplete. Second and 7 on the 7-yard line.
Down, sir.
The ball is snapped, rolls to the left. He's looking for a receiver. He might actually call the run. No, he's going backwards. He's heading to the right. Going deeper and deeper. He is returning back to the right yet again in his short pass.
Oh, and it is touchdown! Touchdown, Reapers.
By Brian Joseph, I believe. Yes. No, it was actually Chris Tucker.
Chris Tucker. Mm-hmm.
27 Reapers, 21 Packers. The game has been flipped over. The ball is in play.
Set for Harambe.
It is up. And it is good.
Score is now Reapers 28, Packers 21. Let's see if the Reapers can keep up their momentum and hold that score.
That interception was key for this momentum swing. Now we just need to, if they can get another intercept, they might just get the ball game.
Running down the middle, heads to the left a little bit, running back to the right. He's looking for room. He gets some extra space. Picks up 30 yards.
Gets first and 10. And he gets tackled by Ricky Ward-Honey, and he picks up 30 yards.
Down, sir. Hike.
Snaps the ball, rolls to the left, rolls back to the right, throws the ball deep. It is caught by Jay Gonzalez and picks up 25 yards. Ball is snapped, rolls to the left, rolls back to the right. This is looking for a receiver. He might have, and there it is, caught by Dante. Picks up 22 yards.
I almost got a tackle there, but he managed to get the throw to complete.
Yeah, he was on his neck. If he didn't get rid of that ball a second later, he would have been down.
Mm-hmm.
Snaps the ball, rolls to the left. Looks like he's going to run, and he's running it. He runs. Oh, my God. Cameron Cora steps out of bounds, picking up the 12 yards. First and 10 on the 14-yard line. Snaps the ball, rolls to the right. Just trying to get rid of his containment, has to get rid of the ball.
And passes incomplete.
Yeah, he had no choice there. It was either get rid of it or risk getting sacked right there. He was surrounded. Snaps the ball, rolls to the right, actually slows down, goes now again, yet again to the right. He has one right behind him. He has to get rid of the ball for a second time. Seems the Reapers are applying a lot more pressure now, trying to keep them away from scoring.
They're trying their best not to get the Packers get another lead over them. They're trying their best to keep the momentum and keep the score in the lead.
Snaps the ball, rolls to the right. Rolls back to the left. The ball is up. And it is intercepted by Chris Tacco on the 2nd yard line. Oh my God. That might just be all that the Reapers need. Now they just need to get out of there without getting a safety. Ball is up. And I believe it was batted down. Yes, it was batted down. 2nd and 10 on the 2nd yard line for the Reapers. Skinner either needs a quick pass, a really quick pass, or needs to run this ball. He's not going to have much time to stay back there. Snaps the ball, rolls to the left, rolls to the right, is out of room. He throws the ball. And the pass is incomplete. It was overthrown. 3rd and 10 on the 2nd yard line. Skinner is not getting any room to get out of there. He needs to figure something out quick.
Or else they're going to get a safety.
And they snap the ball. He rolls to the left. He actually got the blocks. He might actually be able to get out. And he throws the ball deep. And it is caught by Jay Gonzalez to pick up 48 yards. 1st and 10 on the 50-yard line for the Reapers.
Yes, they got the pressure out of the end zone. Now they got some breathing room to get some more plays.
Now he can actually relax and actually has room to run around. He was in danger back there. He was constantly under a lot of pressure with no room to run. I'm surprised he managed to see that and throw that so well.
Once they see, they just throw it and hopefully it will.
Looks like they're taking their time now.
They are taking their very much time.
The ball is snapped, rolls to the right, rolls back to the left. He's being taken deep. It is up and is out of bounds. The intended pass is incomplete. 2nd and 10 on the 50-yard line for the Reapers.
Down, sir.
The ball is snapped, rolls to the right, rolls back to the left. He actually has to go back, throws the ball. Ooh, incomplete. I believe he was looking for Kazi on that play. Yes, he was looking for Kazi. Ball is snapped, rolls to the right, rolls back to the middle, and heads back left. The ball is up, and then is caught by Mr. Extraordinary and brought down by Brian Joseph. Picks up 12 yards. The ball is snapped, rolls to the right. It's being taken back to the deep again. This time it seems there's really good containment. Ball is up, caught by Kazi. She's brought down by Cameron Cora, picks up 6 yards. Seems the Packers are getting their show together now that they're actually containing them a lot harder. They're actually reading the short passes and covering them much closer with less cushion. As for the Reapers, they are milking the clock apparently because they're always waiting at least for 10 seconds before they roll somewhere.
They're breaking the clock.
Down set.
Ball is snapped, rolls to the left. Keeps going down the left. He might actually try and run this, and he is. He gets the yards. First and 10 on a 26-yard line. And yet again, we wait for the clock to tick down. No bigger punishment for the Packers than having to wait, knowing that every second counts in this game.
As I said, it seems they're in the lead, trying to get the team. Ball is that rolls to the right, and he still rolls to the right. And he heads back, and he rolls to the right again. And he throws it, caught by Jay Gonzalez. And he gets tackled by Michael Slade. Picks up 4 yards.
Yeah, the Packers are reading their gameplay. They're forcing Skinner that far back. The receivers have to come back to help him. And it's really crippling their ability to gain yardage.
I called that timeout at 2:01. Can we have that instead of the 2-minute warning and the timeout?
And he's milking down the clock again.
We'll give it back to you. I'm trying to make the other refs tell you no so you can yell at them and nobody will say no.
It's 2 minutes flat now.
What was that? I can hear you.
They want one extra second? That's interesting.
Oh, they're switching players.
Oh, yeah, we're good to go.
Ready?
Yep, there it is. Okay, so apparently they've asked for 1 second back on the clock. That is the most interesting request I've seen so far this season. The ball is snapped, and he rolls to the left, and he rolls back to the right. He's looking for room, and the ball is up deep. Oh, my God, he was left wide open. Mr. Extraordinary. Picks up, oh my God, he was left wide open. Ladies and gentlemen, that was a huge mistake. That 1 second threw everybody off.
34-21. Ball is in play.
Yeah, said all.
the kick is, and it's good. Score is now 35 Reapers, 21 Packers.
This is not looking good for the Packers. First, on the preseason game, it was the 5% that screwed the Reapers over. Now it's going to be the 1 second curse for the Packers. That's what we're going to call it. The 1 second.
For Kaepernick.
You heard it here first, folks. And the ball itself, it is going deep. And it is caught by Cameron Cora running up the middle. Going to the right. Still up, going down the right side. And he's brought down by Ricky Bobby. Picks up 30 yards. First and 10 on the 30-yard line for the Packers. The ball is snapped. And it looks like he might actually go for a run. Oh no, and he throws it deep. Oh, and he misses just a few inches off. All he had to do was keep going. Pressure is on the Packers to score a touchdown and try and get back in this game. The clock is ticking.
Down, sir.
The ball is snapped. Rolls to the left. Ball is up, cross field, down the middle, caught by Brian Joseph. He's brought down by Chris Taco. And there was a timeout now. I do believe that is to stop the clock from rolling.
Yes. Timeout by the Packers. If they are stopping the ball, they're going to play.
They're trying to get as much time as they can with their timeouts. Trying to make something happen here. Ball is snapped, rolls to the right, rolls back to the left, and heads back down the right side, and he is tackled by Santino and loses 8 yards. Second and 18 on the 47-yard line. The ball is snapped, rolls to the left. Ooh, and he gets stumbled. He didn't sprint, and he might have been overconfident.
And he gets tackled by Tozan for you, and he loses 12 yards. The Reapers are giving them a very hard time right now.
Snaps the ball, rolls to the right, is looking for some room, throws it deep, a 50-50, and it is caught by Crevin. He gets tackled by Chris Taco, takes up 32 yards.
Timeout again.
They ask for another timeout. They're trying to keep this clock alive just a little longer so they may get that touchdown.
And they have 30 seconds on the clock.
30 seconds, ladies and gentlemen. We are 30 seconds away from the Reapers beating the Packers.
Ball is in play.
Down, sir.
Snaps the ball and it goes to the left and it goes back to the right. And he throws it.
Deep. Can he catch it?
And it's
caught by Dante for a touchdown.
Packers 27, Reapers 35.
They're so close, ladies and gentlemen. If it hadn't been for those. This might have been a different story right now.
Now, mind you, this is 20 seconds. Anything can change within 20 seconds.
Yes, maybe the fumble gods will hear the pleads from the Packers and give them the ball. 28-35 is the score. Reapers are leading. We're 17 seconds away from calling it a tie between the Packers and the Reapers in the sense of match-wise this season. Preseason, the Packers took it home. This time it might be the Reapers' chance, but will that mean that the next time they face each other, it'll be the Packers again? Who knows? And we are waiting for the kick. Ball's in play.
Down. Tonight.
It's kicked short. There's 14 seconds left on the clock. Can the Packers get a miracle interception? They might. It looks like they're going for this. They've changed their formation. Interesting.
Is this something new?
Yes, it's very interesting.
I don't know what just happened there.
That is the strangest thing I have ever seen. I am not sure what they are doing. And that is the end of the game.
Final score, Reaper 35, Packers 28.
Can I get player of the game?
Great job.
Ladies and gentlemen. Well, honestly, I'm going to say Chris Taco, player of the game.
Yeah,
it's either that or Kazi, but I really think Chris Taco was on today. He was catching a lot of balls. He did have good interceptions. And he basically got down, so I do agree. Chris Taco.
Chris Taco is a player of the game. Congratulations,
congratulations to Chris Taco.
And congratulations.
And the Reapers. Thank you for all of those who joined us via stream. And here I was commentating alongside Jade, who joined me late, but we managed to get somebody to have some fun around here.
Of course.
And we will see you all next time. Have a good night.
Good night, everybody.